hard to get it on the calendar. And if you as an administrator find your event is not on the calendar, if you could send me an email, then I will take care of that and get it on there. It does happen. We try not to let it happen, but it does happen. Okay, is that better? Hold us, it's much easier. Okay, so if you, did you hear me say, if you have an event scheduled and it's not on the calendar, please send me an email. I'll get it put on there right away. We try not to let it happen, but it does happen. One of the problems that we encounter is that every reservation that we have requires 4 manual inputs into different systems, and so one of them could be missed. So just send me an email, I'll get it on the calendar. Or if you see an error on your scheduled event, please let me know as soon as you see it on the calendar, and I'll take care of fixing it right away. All right, there we go. Okay, lodge temperatures. One of the issues here at the lodge is people think that the temperature is either too hot or too cold. The rooms are set individually, and for us to turn a temperature down, say for a dance, like line dance, it takes 2 hours for us to set it down to a lower temperature for the room to get cool. The temperatures here are controlled at the front desk. There are two of the thermostats. From high to low, it's only 4 degrees difference. So if you come here and you're having an event, you would have to go to the front desk to ask them to turn it down lower. If you have a planned event, like a dance, so social dance, line dance, those kinds of things, lifestyle events, we usually automatically go in at 5 o'clock and turn those temperatures down. It may be very cool in here when you first walk in, but believe me, when you start dancing, it warms up real quick. The lighthouse temperature is set at 68 degrees. All the time. We don't have too many problems over there. Most people are comfortable at that temperature. We try and keep it here between 68 and 70. And I do have a monitor on my computer at the front desk that tells me exactly what the temperature is in each room. Right here, they run about 69, 70 degrees on a regular basis. The lifestyle department has 3 people that are in charge. We've just added a 4th person. For reservations and setups, you would speak with me, or now we have Vicki, she's here part-time at the lodge. Then there's Grace. Grace handles our vendor events. So those are the events that you see, the lunch and learns and those type of events. She handles that, the pool staff, and the club newsletter for that you would send in the information. So that's who you would contact. But if you have a reservation, you need to make changes to a reservation, you need to handle any kind of setup for your events or that, you would come here to the lodge and I would take care of that, or Vicki would take care of it. And then we have Cynthia, who oversees Grace and I and Vicki. And in addition, she handles the fitness classes, the chartered clubs, and entertainment for the community, and also the cafe. I'm telling you that because a lot of people say, well, I don't know who to contact about this. So I'm trying to help you understand how the department works so that you don't send something to one of us and it should have gone to someone else and there's that right time of it getting forwarded to the right person. Room and equipment request. For a room request, there is a process. You can go to the Sun City's website and pick up under the documents, there's a room reservation folder, and in there are the room request forms. Please make sure if you're a chartered club, you pick the chartered club form. If you're an interest group or a neighborhood, you would pick up, select that form. Once you bring that to the lodge, you would drop it off here at the lodge. And once you bring that here, we'll make sure that you've signed all the documents that we need for a reservation. Previously, you only needed the request form. Now there's 2 additional forms that have been added. One is the board of directors, help me out here. The board of directors approved conduct, basically. That's, and it's signed by the club president or representative. That's because we are having problems with people not cleaning up after themselves, leaving the rooms in a mess, and it would cost the association a boatload of money to have that taken care of. So we want to make sure now that we have that form signed. We also ask for a setup form that tells us exactly how you want the room set. We now have 3 setup associates, so most of you should be getting your setups. One of the things that I want to clarify on a setup, when you fill out the form and it says on there setup time, that doesn't mean what time you get in the room. That means what time do you want our guys to set up the room. And it cannot be set up any more than 90 minutes prior to, and only if that time is available. Most times it's only a 30-minute setup allowed. We are currently booked out at 80% of the facilities are booked out for 2017. So any reservations that are coming in now, you have to be very flexible in order to get space in either of the facilities. Once you drop your form off here, you will, we have the process, we say up to 7 days. Usually you'll get a response in 2 to 3 business days, but it can take up to 7 days depending on how many reservations are coming in. Once we have booked the room, you'll get an email stating that the space has been booked and we need you to come to the lodge and sign the confirmation. At that time, you'll get a copy of the permit, and the permit gives you all the details of your reservation. Please look over those permits. That's where you're going to find if there's been a mistake made. At that time, we can make that change, but if 6 months down the road you say, hey, I booked this for December, and here it is, and the time isn't right, it's a lot harder to change the time because other people have come in and made bookings. So please, when you get the permit, and you sign for it, you're signing it, you accept the times that are in that permit. So be sure to review that. Right now the kitchens have, the kitchens have, the kitchens have now been locked at the lake house. Many of you have gone in there and seen that the air wall is pulled and the kitchen door is locked. That is because we have had a problem with people leaving dishes in the sink and in the dishwasher and thinking that the dish fairies are going to come and do your dishes and put them away for you. And we don't have dish fairies here at Sun City. So we were having to pay the cleaning company to do that, to put away dishes and clean up the kitchen. So in order to stop that, the board gave us the approval to go ahead and lock those doors. So if you have an event coming up and you need the kitchen, you need to request that. If you have made a reservation for 2017 and you did not reserve the kitchen, send me an email and say, hey, we have this event coming up. We're going to need the kitchen. We'll make sure it's unlocked for you. There is a new form that has come out. Again, the board is very aware of these situations. And this is a kitchen cleaning procedure. This tells you step by step what's required of you to utilize the kitchen and to clean up after yourself. If the club leaves the kitchen in disarray, they will be charged $100. And they will lose all of their privileges until that fee is paid. So make sure that you follow that. You don't want food left in the fridge because it sits there and then someone has to come and clean the fridge. We don't want things left out on the counter. Just take everything with you that you brought in and everything will be fine. Dishes put away. Don't leave any in the sink or in the dishwasher. Those will be checked. If you spill stuff in the oven, make sure that you clean that up or make arrangements to get it cleaned up. If you have equipment that you need, say you come and you need a mic for your event, we can take care of it. You come to the front desk at either location, we'll take care of setting that up for you. Here at the lodge, we have a audio system in the back that we hook all the sound up, the TVs up, the screen up, the projectors up at the lake house. The projector has to be turned on at the front desk, and then once again it has to be turned on at the panel, and Greg will show you how to do that. The Creston system over at the lodge, there, we have been having some problems with that. They have come in and done a repair on it recently. We hope it's going to last until they do the upgrades. So, Lake House is due for an upgrade this spring. All that equipment is 10 years old, and if you know anything about technology, you know that it doesn't last 10 years. So currently, it is up and working. If we have a problem with it again, we are prepared. We have portable mics and portable speakers, and we'll help you out with that. When you go down the hallway across from the ballrooms is the card room and the craft room, and there are window displays there. If your club would like to utilize those, there is a form at the front desk, and you can see Robin about that, and she will schedule a time for your club to have that. Those displays are scheduled out for 2 months at a time, and she generally schedules them about 4 months in advance. So if you're interested in having those, be sure to fill out the proper documentation so that she can get that scheduled for you. Channel 15, Greg, has there been an update on that or no? Okay.
Corporate has not gotten back to...
Okay. Channel 15 is currently not working. It's a Corporate issue. They are aware of it, and the technology committee has been working with them. Yes, sir?
You have channel 115 out there.
Oh, 115, I'm sorry. Yeah, 115. I don't have Comporium, so I don't know. Thanks. 115. Yeah, 115. At the lake house, many of you know there's the lobby board when you come in the front there, and it lists all the events going on. That is one of the places that manual input is done to put that on there. And each day takes about an hour to an hour and a half to put items on there. That project is done usually 3 to 4 days in advance. So at the time that it's built, the information is correct. If someone cancels something, it usually does not come off of there because it takes another hour to hour and a half to remove that item off of there. So while we try really hard to have the information for you, if you come in and you see that, just be aware that there may have been a change at the last minute and we just are unable to get that change on there quick enough. Most of the time when that happens, it's the day before the information came to us about 5 o'clock as we're walking out the door and there's no way for us to get it on there unless I want to work from home and I really don't want to do that. Emails to club members, this is going to be going away. Right now, clubs are sending out emails to your own clubs, but then there are some of you that are sending information to every club that you're in to try and get your information out to them. That is not allowed here at Sun City, and we are buckling down on that. If we find that's happening, we will contact you and let you know that it's not allowed. You as a club member or administrator are only allowed to send emails pertaining to your club and send it to only your club. Okay? Displaying poster boards, there is on the community homepage under documents in the, I believe it's in the charter club information, there is a poster board document that was put out by the board as to what you can put, what the size of the poster board is. Many of you may have noticed we've gotten away from the tripods that was everyone was tripping over in them. They're now, the poster boards are now in frames and they're up on the walls so you can view them as you go down the hall. These are usually events, some of them are clubs, some of them are lifestyle events, and any poster that's made by a club needs to be approved by Cynthia. Please do that prior to printing because we've had several that have come back and do not meet the criteria that was set for them, and we've had to refuse them, and then you've spent the money on that poster. So be sure to check that out to make sure that you're following the guidelines that were set up. Grace sends out an email blast that tells you all the events that are going on for clubs for the week. This information has been received from the clubs that send the information to Grace, and that should be sent Wednesday prior to the posting as to what you want to go in that blast. And then she'll get that out to all the residents. So be sure to get that to her the Wednesday prior to the posting. And then any articles for the Living magazine need to go in 2 months prior to the event. And so that also includes information that comes from our lifestyle department. So sometimes you may go in there and not see something posted because it was booked after that 2 month time frame. Forms, the audiovisual guidebook. There's one at the Lake House. I don't know if any of you have seen it. It's in Ballroom A over on the counter, and it gives you a guide to how to use the system over there. Greg Powell did a wonderful job of building this booklet, and it tells you step by step. If you follow this step by step, you'll be able to use the system over at the Lake House without any problem, as long as the Crestone's working. there's also a technology problem sheet. If you go over there and you're trying to get it to work and there's a problem, please fill that out so that the right people can get in there and get it fixed. Once, I mentioned this before, but once you go to the front desk and say, hey, I need you to turn on the projector, there is a button in the ballroom that also needs to go on, and again, Greg will show you that. And then you have to sign out any microphones, so be sure to have your ID badges to turn in, and then they'll give them back once the mics are returned. The media room remote, again, that needs to be checked out. If you're going to be down in the media and using the TV, again, you'll be asked for your ID, and you have to leave that until you drop it back off and you get your ID back. Here at the lodge, things are done a little bit differently. We can control these shades here in the rooms, but that's all done through the front desk. At the Lake House, you just go over, you get the buttons on the panel, and it drops. Here, this is all remote controlled, and we have the remotes in the back. And so most of the technology over here requires someone from the front desk to handle it for you. The system in the back is about a $100,000 piece of equipment, and so they do not want residents poking around in there. I can tell you just from staff poking around in it that we run into problems. We just recently had the processor replaced on that, and thank God we could say that it was only a couple of people that had used that system so that they couldn't blame it on you know, someone poking around in it. We will have the room set up for you. Now this says lodge front desk, but this is for all facilities now. With three setup men, we've been able to accommodate most of the setups. It's rare that we can't set it up to your request, and sometimes things are overlapping. So we are budgeted for one person on at a time. And so our guy may have three rooms that need to be set up at 3 o'clock. And so just give him a minute or two, and he'll try and get you as close to your setup time as possible. But with both buildings, he may be over here and then have to run over to the Lake House too. So we ask, with us being so booked, that we work, you know, trying to understand that. Here again, we turn on the projectors and the TVs. The projectors, all of this is handled in our audio system in the back. HDMI cables can be checked out at the front desk. We have one for each of the rooms. The one here at the lodge, or at this ballroom 3, is a 25 footer. That is the longest one we have. If you need one longer than that, you'll have to provide it. Some people have said, well, we want to be in the middle of the room and face the stage, and we just don't have a cable long enough. So figure about 25 feet, As you can see, it's plugged in way back there, so you have to account for the stage too. It's not a problem if you stand at the podium like we are here, but if you're wanting to be in the middle of the room, it's not going to work for you, okay? The ones in either of the front ballrooms, those, they're about 12 feet, so they should work fine. We have a credenza in each room that your computers can sit on, and so you won't need any kind of stand to put it on. And the small rooms back here, if the divider is open, so you have one and two combined, then both TVs will work if you need the TVs, then both of them will be on. If the divider wall is up, then each TV in each room works independently. So there can be someone in ballroom one having an event, and someone in ballroom two having a different event, and their TVs are working independently. In the main ballroom here, we can turn, as you can see, there's two side TVs here. We can turn those on in addition to the screens here in the front. Whatever portraying up on the screens here will also portray on those side screens. If all the walls are down, then what's ever up on the screen will also go on the back TVs. Okay, this is a picture of the panels that you'll find in ballrooms one and two, our back rooms here. And as you can see, there is a spot for, can you see the blue light on there? Okay, that tells us what kind of input. Nine times out of 10, you're using an HDMI, and we'll set this up for you, but it will have a blue light on. If you turn that off, you're not going to get any reception through that HDMI, so just leave it alone. We'll have it set up for you. And then you just plug the HDMI in, and I always call it a plug-and-play system, because you plug it into the HDMI into that panel, and you plug it into your computer. Whatever on your computer is going to show right on those TVs. It's that simple. It doesn't require anything special. Probably the biggest problem I have is someone coming in with a computer that doesn't have an HDMI input. And then we run into a problem. Then on the walls in ballrooms one and two, this is your AV panel. So we'll have the system turned on. And when you come in, you can just go over and hit that power TV button on, and it will turn that TV on for you. You'll see the buttons on the left that say mute, mic 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't touch them. They don't mean anything to you. They're not even active, so don't even worry about them. On the right, you'll see the source volume. You can change the volume of your computer that you're using right from there, from that panel, or you can control it from your computer, either or. And then this is showing you the configuration up here in the front. Most of you will only be using the audio feed, which is the top button. Again, we'll have the top panel. We'll have that plugged in. That's what the HDMI is plugged into. The other units that you see there are generally used when we have a band. It's to allow for their sound system and the lighting here. Then we also have this panel which sits up here. This is where we would turn the TV on. If you are using the projector over here, once you are done, there's a power button off for the projector. We appreciate if you turn it off because those lamps and that projector is about $500 a piece. We have two projectors here. So we ask that once you're done with it, just walk up and hit that button to help us save money on replacing those. Where'd Daniel? Over by Dan, you'll see there's this is a picture of three panels over there. The only panel you're going to be interested in is the one he's playing with right now, and this is what it looks like. And it's the Lodge lighting panel. So scene one, you got that on, because all the lights in here are turned on. Scene two, we'll turn down the lights a little bit. We usually have the lights set like this for dinner events. It's about where you want the lighting. And scene three, if you're doing a presentation up here, it makes it a lot easier to turn the lights down and see the presentations up here. And scene four turns everything off along with the bottom light bulb turns everything off, so it's pretty dark in here. You can adjust those yourselves. Those are the four scenes that we've got set up. So if you're having an event here, you're welcome to go over and turn the lighting on to whatever scene you'd like that'll work for your event. But just make sure that someone's not over there and keep playing with the buttons and that. It's a pretty simple system, but there's only four different scenes on that. I'm going to show you a couple of the panels that you don't need to be interested in. I just want to show you them so that you know this is something you shouldn't be touching, okay? A lot of people look at this and if any of you have been here for a dance and they'll say, boy, it's hot in here. And they go over and they hit this panel because they see an up and down button. And they figure it's the thermostat. It has nothing to do with the thermostat. This is a panel that is used only for the mics for when we have a band here. And they totally control this whole thing. So it has nothing to do with you, so you don't have to worry about it. I actually have a note on it that says, this is not a thermostat. Okay. One of the other issues here at the lodge is that if it's very warm in here, people will go and crank the doors open over here. When you pop that door open, you have just turned the air conditioning system off. So if you think opening those doors is going to bring some air in here, you've just turned this into an oven. It's better to go to the front desk and say, please turn the air down in there. This panel here, this lodge lighting panel, again, is one that you don't need to worry about, don't need to touch. It does the same thing as that 1, 2, 3, 4 over there that we just showed you. And this is another one of the panels, and again, it has nothing to do with you, don't need to worry about it. That's our TVs here, they're all 70-inch.